Hello and welcome to a special edition of Currently in Quincy, The Interviews. I'm Joe Catalano here with George Nicholson, Director of Veterans Services for the City of Quincy, to talk about Memorial Day celebration. I won't say it's more of a commemoration or at least a recognition that's held, of course, every year on this year, May 27th. So, George, good to see you.
Good to be back here.
Yeah.
Again.
And I'm always careful to say it's not a celebration. It's a commemoration.
It's a commemorative. Kind of thing. Yeah. Absolutely.
Tell us, for folks who don't know, a little bit about how Memorial Day got its founding start, if you could.
Well, the genesis for it dates back to the Civil War.
Right.
America, as even though the population wasn't all that great, it made it very significant that the casualty rate was so extraordinary in the Civil War. And there were Civil War veterans on both sides in virtually every cemetery across the country. Mm-hmm. And at that time, there was an organization in the Midwest of ladies who had started going out around the first end of May, when flowers were in bloom at the time, and decorating those graves so they wouldn't be forgotten. And then the Grand Army of the Republic, which was the organization of Civil War veterans, led by General Logan. General Logan issued orders for the Grand Army to commemorate this day all across the land in whatever form of ceremony they choose, and to do it on a permanent and a perpetual basis, as long as we breathe, that we'd have somebody there to honor those who gave their lives and who served and are no longer with us.
Right.
And it's been a tremendous holiday for America since then.
Was it Decoration Day?
Originally, it started. Over the years, it has evolved. It's been Decoration Day, and then in the 50s, it became Memorial Day. It made after the Second World War and now the Korean War. Uh-huh. We weren't just decorating old graves anymore. There were plenty of new, fresh ones.
Unfortunately, right?
Yeah. Unfortunately.
Yeah.
And that's how it took hold, and it became the adopted child of all the veterans organizations around, not just the Grand Army of the Republic, as the Grand Army, the Civil War vets died away.
Sure.
You know, the torch was passed on to the other organizations, and it continues today. The sad part today is that it's a big decrease in the number of towns and observances that are happening around the state and around the country, actually, because of the decrease in active veteran population.
Yeah.
I know. So it becomes a struggle to maintain the date, maintain its significance, and maintain its celebration, its commemoration, being honored.
Right, yeah. It is celebrating the lives of those lost, right, certainly.
That's correct.
Yeah. Yeah. Here in Quincy, it's not been difficult or a struggle to
keep
going.
In the City of Presidents, as I understand that, I don't know how the legislation passed, but I know that there was a motion on the floor in the legislature yesterday up in the state, up in Beacon Hill, to recognize the City of Quincy as the state's most patriotic city.
Is that right?
I don't know how that came out.
I'm sure you don't.
I'm pretty sure there'd be some opposition from somebody, but I certainly think that'd be right.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did not know that, actually.
And the Quincy has always maintained and strove and still does to make sure that Memorial Day is honored in a huge way. And we do that very effectively. Normally he would be here today, but this is the time of the year where the schedule gets hectic.
Right.
For George and for myself. And George Bouchard, who's my graves registration officer, has been out around the clock in the rainy weather and everything, getting things set up. So Scott Logan and the cemetery superintendent of the cemetery and his crew have just done phenomenal work, and this day in that cemetery, that's for George Bouchard, for my graves registration office, this is a labor of love. This is his baby.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, speaking of that, he undertook not too long ago kind of a personal project of his own, right, to restore grave markers up at Mount Wollaston.
One of the things that you will see in Mount Wollaston that's new this year, if you look up to where the Civil War monument is.
Yep.
All those cannons,
yep,
which originally came from the USS Constitution, they came from old Ironsides. Oh. They've all been stripped and repainted. Mm-hmm. And the marble headstones for the Civil War vets that are there, the 16 of them, over the centuries with acid rain and everything, that they've just eroded to the point where some of the inscriptions were becoming illegible. So George took it upon himself to, he went out, and we ordered brand new headstones, mm-hmm, for all of them.
Wow.
They've now been installed.
Really?
Okay. Scott and the crew are taking care of the landscaping. And so that's going to be something very special to take a look at.
Okay.
A fresh view of the Civil War Memorial up at Mount Wollaston.
Wow. Okay.
Takes a brand new perspective with everything been revamped.
Yeah, and it's been a challenge with the weather this spring,
rejuvenated,
to do anything.
It's been an extreme challenge.
Yeah, well, great for him. That's
we went out a couple of weeks ago, and I'd like to take the opportunity,
please,
to thank all the kids and the parents who brought kids, the ROTC, and everyone who came out a couple of weeks ago to help us put the flags on the rest of Mount Wollaston.
Mm-hmm.
There's like 3,700 flags.
Wow.
That went out. They came out in bunches and just ran all over the cemetery,
yep,
in no time.
Many hands make
done.
Light work, right?
Yeah. We saved the veterans plot in front for the last. That's George's baby.
Okay.
And you'll see when you go by on C Street now, as you look over at Mount Wollaston, George makes it a backbreaking point to go out and make sure all the flag holders,
yes,
are perfectly aligned.
Really? Okay.
All the they're all new flags in there. And as always, on a sunny day with a slight breeze, that's a fantastic sight.
It's
a
it's
very moving
stunning,
sight to see
actually. It really
900
is.
Of them out there.
Yes, yeah.
So we're praying that that whole weather stays with us.
Yes.
That this rain is going to be gone for...
Hopefully we're turning the corner.
Not
yeah.
till July, yeah, maybe, when so we need it again, but for
speaking
now...
Speaking of flags, right behind me, the picture of the flags for Veterans Island over at Fort Square, that's been redone. It was a scout project.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was... I used to joke with Paul Moody when they first put it up about how you were going to find flags for your relatives and stepping on and
right.
flags. Roll. And then we had the Boy Scout came in and for his Eagle Scout project,
yeah,
with the help of a surveyor, they gridded the entire facility.
Right.
So now whatever direction you look at the island from, everything is lined
yes.
up in a row.
In perfect military
and
style,
perfect
right?
military style.
Absolutely. It really is quite stunning, and it's well worth
the... As I told Paul the other night when he told me that the scout had done that,
yep.
I said the other night I went by, I said, listen, Paul, on the way back to the office the other day, I did a 360 all around the island.
Just to make sure.
My compliments to the guys. They did a nice
yeah,
job.
Yeah, so. Very nice. And kudos to that scout.
Absolutely.
For sure.
I wish I could think of his name. I forgot to bring
yeah,
it with me.
I can't either. He's featured in the Quincy Sun this week.
Well, he'll be mentioned Sunday, too. So.
Oh, very good. Yeah, yeah, so let's talk about the activities for this year's Memorial Day.
This is coming up. There's a big lead up. Right now, during this week, all the veterans organizations are putting out the memorial wreaths. Around all the poles. We'll start, as I say, it's a busy week. Mm-hmm. The schools get involved now. Next Friday is an open invitation from Snug Harbor School, 9:00. They do the kids in the first to the fifth grade all come out with a presentation.
Oh, okay.
Songs
okay.
and stuff. And
so that's May 24th?
Friday, May 24th, 9:00 in the morning. There'll be a collation at the Germantown Center afterwards.
Very good.
And we're inviting as many people as can come out for that to do it.
Okay.
This something new this year on the 31st, Montclair School, the fifth graders, the band, the orchestra.
Yeah.
Is putting on a veterans memorial tribute
oh.
concert.
Okay.
So the school is looking to have veterans come into the auditorium at 1:00 so the kids can serenade them.
Very nice.
With what they've been practicing for a long time.
Oh,
so I would
sweet.
Encourage
okay.
if you've got time. On the 31st, please come on board.
Okay.
And come on out for that. Getting back to Memorial Day itself,
yep.
it always, traditionally, it started with the, we have a memorial service at the Sailor's Lot Cemetery on Fennel Street.
Oh, all right. Sailor's Home Pond.
The Sailor's Pond,
yep.
right. That's been refurbished as well.
Mm-hmm.
And that was always at 7:00 in the morning, and it gets a little tough for some people to make. So that now will take place at 8:00.
Okay. Like an extra hour.
And then, yeah.
Very good.
So, and it's a brief ceremony, so it doesn't take a long time.
Okay.
Hopefully by then the mud will have dried up. It'll be a pleasant walk up to the cemetery.
Yes, yes.
If you've ever been to it. Memorial Day itself, we're setting up. We've got a good-sized parade coming this year. We've got 7 bands for a little entertainment along the way in the 3 divisions. We've got honor guards from the Coast Guard, from the USS Constitution. We've got the Army Honor Guard. Our guest speaker is going to be the commander of the Coast Guard based out in Cape Cod, Derek Smith, who's a fun guy to be around.
Okay.
And we will marshal, we'll assemble at 10 o'clock down in the parking lot of the Quincy Credit Union.
Yep.
And we'll step off at 10:30, and we'll have, we stop on the way at the President's Church, get down and put their memorial wreaths on the tombs of both presidents, resume the march on down to the Mount Wollaston, and the ceremony starts at 11.
Okay. Now, are you going through the new Hancock Adams Common, or are you going behind?
No, we're still going. We're going to cut to the side of it.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, very good.
I don't know when or if we'll, at this point, if they'll ever plan to. Well, that's only speculation on my part.
Yeah.
We didn't have any problem just stopping along the side of the President's Church and dropping in. It's always a couple minutes, so a few more steps didn't make any difference.
Yes, yeah.
And then on we go. And it's going to be, we're looking forward to this one because George, again, this is his baby. He's worked very hard for months on this.
Mm.
So the last thing we want to have to do is move all this into the auditorium at Quincy High School if it rains,
that's
at 11 o'clock.
Yeah.
That's the contingency. All right. If we get rained out, we'll put notice into QATV.
Sure.
And so you'll be notified ahead of time if the parade, because of inclement weather, has to be canceled. And we will hold the ceremony inside in the auditorium. Seats are much more comfortable in there than in the gym.
Yeah. So. Yes, and the sound system is much better as well. You'll actually be able to hear what's going on.
Yeah, without the echo.
Correct.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Very good.
So that's the general plan.
Okay. And as always, you encourage folks, of course, to line the parade routes and show their support.
One of the things that we look for, we work hard. George does it. I do it. My whole office staff gets involved in this. We put it together the best we can. And it's always nice because there's always a decent crowd down in front of Mount Wollaston for the ceremony itself.
Mm-hmm.
What we'd like to see, if it's possible, is just more people along the parade route.
Yes.
You won't be out there very long. We're not talking a mile-long parade procession.
And there's bands to entertain.
And there's plenty of bands to entertain. Some of them are walking. Some of them are riding on floats.
Sure.
But we got it covered. We'll get as many of the veteran units and what's left of them as we can.
Yes.
They're out there. And we're looking forward to it. And George will identify the bands and the groups as they come by the reviewing stand.
Okay.
Et cetera.
Where is that set up, George?
That'll be set up right across the street from Mount Wollaston.
Oh, okay.
Right in front of the police station.
Yep. Very good. Something I did want to ask you then, you're familiar, of course, with the mayor's plan to do a new whole public safety complex where the police station is now and also include the Department of Veterans Services. Is that something that you think is
the game plan is, well, the mayor wants us to be a little less remote.
Yes. Yeah. You're over on High School Avenue, right?
Yeah.
Right.
You know, we're behind the fire station.
I don't have
a particular problem with it. We got parking. It's a nice location.
Yeah.
But for those of you who don't know, the Little Red Schoolhouse, its history, it's actually Quincy's first high school.
That's right.
Built in 1852.
Yeah. It has its challenges.
It has its history and its challenges, yes. But I've done all the legwork that the consultants requested to give them the specifics for space and offices and stuff that we'd need to continue this. And the game plan is apparently that when they start the project, assuming it's funded and it gets going.
Right, still conceptual right now.
We're talking it's conceptual at this point.
Right.
Is they would put up the new building.
Yep.
They will move, when the building is complete and the parking lot's in, they will move the police department out of their building into there.
Yep.
They will then demolish the police building.
Right.
down to the footing.
Yep.
Put in the addition, the wing to it, and when that's up, we'll be in the corner.
Oh, all right.
The front corner of that building.
Okay.
So we'll be one of the last vestiges to move when the time comes.
Okay. Really, with the front row seat of
the
Wollaston Cemetery.
And Mount Wollaston Cemetery, yeah. So we can watch the accidents and we can watch the flags both. So it's
let's hope just the latter and not the former. But right, exactly.
It's a tough intersection.
Yeah. But I'm sure there are probably, you know, veterans who say, where is our Veterans Services Department? How do we find them? You know?
So yeah, that's true, because you have to find the you have to leave Hancock Street and go on to Quincy Avenue.
Right.
And at the fire station, you take the left, and we're down in there behind. We have a nice operation.
Tucked in, and you're dead end, yeah.
We're tucked in.
Yep.
We had the Home Depot a couple of years ago came out and did a volunteer revamping of the front of the building.
Oh, okay. Didn't know that.
You know, fixing the ramp and painting and replacing the rails and
stuff.
Sure. Planting some stuff. So the building looks good.
Okay.
What its future is ultimately after we're out of there, I have no idea.
Right.
Yeah. If it goes like anything else, it's, again, speculation. It could become another apartment complex. There's room down there for it, except for the parking. For it.
But in the meantime, you are there and you're available.
We are there.
Of course, yeah.
And as I said when I did the Veterans Corner thing the other day, come on down.
Yeah.
There's a lot of information we have. There's a lot of ways we can help.
Yes, absolutely.
And I'm looking forward to getting this day done after the parade.
Yep.
You know, we have the collation. We'll be back at the Morissette Post afterwards.
Over on Liberty Street, yeah.
We usually have. And I do it every year. I just pray for good weather. Pray for good weather.
I know. It will happen either way.
And this year, I'm praying for good weather. After all this rain, it's been brutal.
It has been. And it's been a challenge for the cemetery workers as well, you know, to get things ready for the season. Because it's not only is it for veterans and their families on Memorial Day, but it's become kind of bigger than that, really, when folks kind of go visit their family plots and spruce them up for the season as well.
Yeah, and it's, and the, I've had George and Linda Pershard, who's an amateur historian, does fantastic work for us. When we do the Wreaths Across America in December, this year we're going to do the entire city.
Really? Okay.
All seven cemeteries.
Wow.
The mayor was so impressed with what we had for a ceremony at Mount Wollaston, and his family members and the wreaths that he was able to lay.
Right. So
why not? Let's see if we can do it for the entire city.
Okay.
So he's going to see
that
it takes place. Right now we're looking at, the count is just a little over 7,500 graves.
Wow.
Between the seven cemeteries.
That's amazing.
And
okay.
It's that means the committee has got to raise about $109,000 roughly to meet that.
Okay.
So it's a challenge.
It's significant, yeah.
But we pull it off, we'll be the first city in the country to do a citywide.
Is that right?
Wreaths Across America.
Okay. And the interesting thing is, you know, regardless if somebody donates or not, they will get a wreath. And you'll, you know,
we buy enough wreaths for everything.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
As if we can. And we found out we had more graves than we had thought at Mount Wollaston.
Right.
But last weekend, George Saturday and Linda and two other people went out and they literally walked the entire Mount Wollaston Cemetery.
Yep.
Every inch of it.
Wow.
Every grave, took all the details so that we know this time we have an accurate count.
Okay.
won't come up short.
Yeah.
And we'll do the same thing. We'll when that comes, we'll talk more about that later on.
Yes, as it gets closer, yeah. But, you know, for folks who can't get to the cemeteries, what a comfort, you know, and what a nice thought to know that there's going to be something at their loved one's grave, yeah.
You can go online and you can make a donation.
Yeah, that's
in
right.
In your name to Wreaths Across America and the names of a loved one. And
yes.
You know that somebody's going to get it. And if, as we encouraged them last year, we'll do it again this year.
Yep.
If you have a relative that's entombed up there and would you like to place the wreath, that was an extraordinary thing for a lot of people because this was the first time.
Yes.
That renews some significant meaning.
And I know
to honoring the memory.
And a lot of young people got involved with that as well, which was really
well,
nice.
Well, this is what we, you know, the veterans organizations, we're fading. The city of Quincy, most of us at this point are Vietnam vets.
Mm-hmm.
There's some Korean vets, the World War II vets are getting down to I don't know, less than 200 mm-hmm. in the city, I think.
Wow, okay.
And so, you know, we have to share the legacy. We've got to get the younger generation.
What about the personnel vets, George? Where are they?
I introduced a motion the other night at the Quincy Veterans Council to start plans for putting a monument in for the Gulf War vets.
The Gulf War vets. It was 1991, right?
So it's August 2, 1990 is the start of
okay.
it.
Okay. You know. All right.
It's interesting, as I found out, there's a little bit of parochialism. It's not the appropriate word, I think. Mm-hmm. Guys that served in the OIF thing, the Afghan War, consider the Gulf War to have been different.
Oh, interesting.
You know, and okay. you had Desert Storm, Desert Shield, the Persian Gulf, yeah. Gulf War, Afghan,
all separate.
Iraq. But those are actually separate battles.
Well, true, yeah.
Arrangements.
Right.
But the thing is that federally, that period is still open.
Okay.
It was the war date was started, set by Congress, is August 2nd, 1990.
Yeah.
And to be a date as yet to be determined. So this is America's longest war.
Wow.
And for categorization, it's called the Gulf War.
Yes.
Since the start of the Gulf War, we have a little over 1,350 men and women out of the city of Quincy have served during that time.
Okay.
Where they are, we don't know.
We've
yet
okay.
to come out of the woodwork.
Really?
So as we start the ball rolling to put a committee together, and it's a complicated thing. We've got to find a spot for it.
Mm.
You need a committee to fundraise and, you know, determine
yep.
the monument and the location,
yes,
the ceremony,
yes.
all of that stuff down the line. And we need the Gulf War vets to start coming out and making themselves known. I had a member of the Dennis Keenan from the Quincy Police Department approach me about it about 2 weeks ago. And I said, you know, there's a lot on my plate. That needs to be on it, too.
Sure.
And
well,
I'd
for their benefit, too, because there are things that they need to take advantage of, right?
They're the only ones that aren't recognized at this point.
Right.
And they more than deserve the Gulf War vets.
Right.
They're honored by the entire nation.
Yep.
Much better received and taken care of than their predecessors.
The Vietnam vets, right?
And
yeah.
They deserve the monument.
Yes.
And the city owes it to them, and the most patriotic city in America.
That's right.
We'll do that anyway, I'm sure.
Right.
Talk
exactly.
to the mayor. This is just the opening salvo. I got the approval of the Veterans Council.
Okay.
So who knows when that'll happen.
Okay.
So we want the monument out, and the other message is I'd like to see the Gulf War vets starting to make themselves known.
Step one is you give you a call, right?
You can give us a call
yeah.
just to let us know if you've got an organization that's in the city that you have a chapter that we're not aware of.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Let us know.
Okay.
Join up with the existing organizations for the numbers.
Yep.
And you know, guys ask, why should I join one of the veterans organizations? I'm not interested. Or, you know, they don't have the same philosophy that I do or
yeah.
whatever.
Yeah.
Myriad of stories and excuses and justifications
right.
For why they haven't been joining. But the fact of the matter is, when you belong to one of those organizations, that's a vote. Usually, if I represent myself, but I have a wife and I have kids.
That's right.
That's me and four other votes
yep.
that Congress would recognize.
Yep.
And it's the significance of the vote as represented by the veterans organizations that dictates the success and failure of legislation for veterans.
There's power in numbers.
So
yeah.
extremely important.
Yeah.
If no other reason, just the power in numbers.
Okay.
And to be a card-carrying member, just to accomplish that, is all I would ask of anybody.
Okay.
I'm not going to really, even though I've been active in all the organizations,
mm-hmm.
Gone through the chairs, et cetera, and all that, I wouldn't necessarily put that on somebody, and it's up to them whether they want to.
Of course, yeah.
But having the membership, having that voting power to present to Congress when they do the combined veterans committees before the combined sessions and look at veterans legislation for the coming year, Congress looks at those numbers.
Sure.
And, you know, you might have 2.3 million veterans in part of your organization, like the Legion does, but that expands to 8 or 9 million when you stop to think about
the
rest of the families
and, relatives, yeah.
and
yeah.
the relatives, and yep. you can extrapolate far beyond that.
Yes. So in the short term, it's the annual Memorial Day parade here in Quincy, May 27th, and a gathering at the credit union at 10 a.m.?
10 o'clock.
Okay.
We stage at 10. We step off at 10:30.
Okay.
And we're looking, we're putting on a good parade. Love to see you turn out for it. Bring the kids. I know it's always a holiday weekend.
Right.
The tail end of it.
You can have your barbecue in the afternoon.
You can have your barbecue. Nobody has a barbecue in the morning.
That's right.
Anyway.
No, the pancakes will burn on the grill.
You go out for breakfast, go stand on the sidewalk and join. Just wave. Enjoy the bands. Enjoy the military units when they come through.
Sure.
The pageantry that goes with it. And you may be enjoying the parade, but just the very fact that you came out is tacit demonstration of your understanding of the commemoration of that day.
That's right. Yeah.
And as I say, if you come down and take a look at the Mount Wollaston Cemetery, Pine Hill has done the same way. But Pine Hill is a little recessed, so you don't see much.
Right.
It's awe inspiring to see what we have out in front.
George, thanks for the information.
Thanks for having me over here, John.
Always a pleasure, and thank you for your service as well.
You're welcome. My pleasure.
Thank you for joining us today on Currently in Quincy. Again, do come out to the annual Quincy Memorial Day Parade. QuincyMA.gov is the city website. You can access the Veterans Services Department through the website or give them a call, 376-1192, right to George Nicholson. Thanks for joining us.